one I'd like to show you is the Kerria Japonica. It's a lovely spring bush, not a flower. I mean, it is a flower, but it grows on a bush instead of a stem. And these can get quite large, anywhere from 4 to 5 feet wide by maybe 4 to 6 feet tall. So it's one that you probably would want to keep pruned back, like my grandfather did for my grandmother. So there is a branch in the die. Then you've got a series of petals to stack. The largest one has on it to cut 4. Then you've got a smaller one here, the next size down, 3. So you're going to cut 4 of this, 3 of this, and then the last 2 sizes, 2 each. And then this one has what's called a serrated leaf, very jagged, but very distinctive to this bush and easy to do. So let's get started and see how quick this one goes together. I've colored some of the leaves, some of the petals. This is the largest one here. It is a bright yellow, kind of like the forsythia. So I'm going to quickly put some color on that, this piece too, as well. Here's the other 3, because there was 4 of those that we cut. I'm going to flip it over here and color the underside, the wrong side. So these 3 I haven't done any shaping to yet, and I'll show you, I'm going to show you why. These are because they're stackable and they're printed. I'm going to spritz them with a little bit of water, and then I'm just going to use my detail tweezers here, the small pickups. And as you can see, as I pinch around the end of the tweezer, I'm holding it, and I'll continue to hold that one while I get to the next one. So you really get a nice pinch. And I'm going to do this. This is that next size. Yeah, you really do need these small pickups to be able, and it comes in the kit, so a toolkit. You have a nice set of pickup tweezers as well. And then for this last one, you can either use a, this is just an art eraser, or here's a carving block I like to use. And I'm going to take and put in my leaf tool, because this is kind of hard to do with the tweezers to get that tiny little bend in the petal. So I'm using the leaf tool to do that. And I just kind of flip it around, and you do that. There's 2 of these that get cut. And I'm actually going to even cup it on this harder surface, because it really gives a nice cupping. But for these other 2 pieces, I'm going to bring in my molding mat here. And I've got this tool, works fine. I'm going to cup the centers. So all your pieces are done. I'm going to let them dry a second. Here's that branch. Now you've noticed I've cut it out of 2 different colors. It doesn't say to do that on the die. I always double up on my branches or my stems, because it just makes for a easier surface there. Now I'm going to add some glue down the center of this darker brown one. And I've done just brown. I mean, you could do them both white. You could do them both in brown. Put this back in. And then I'm going to put the white branch. The reason why is I'm going to color shade this branch a little bit. So I cut mine out of white, but you certainly don't have to. You can use colored cardstock and save yourself some time. So I've got a couple of brown. Let's see. Maybe this one. I always start with the darker color to shade underneath. And just haphazardly, doesn't have to. And then with that little lighter color, you're going to do the blending. So if you pull that color and blend it, you get some lighter highlights on your stem or your branch. Just gives it a little, and I make sure there's no white showing. So I've actually turned this upright, so in case I see any white. There we go. Now I'm going to bring in my project here. So I have something already started, and I've done a branch. So just putting these together, let's start, let me get some glue and we'll start putting them together. So this branch can take a little bit more than one. You see where the little areas are. So I'm just going to start with that larger petal, and you're going to place four. So I'm going to put four right on top of each other, offsetting, so you get that nice flared look. So if you go right in between those petals there. Sure, I've got all my petals here. I've got a little bit of glue on here. Here's that next number three, and then number four. And then you've got that, here's that one here. That's the three, you cut three of these, and we've shaped them. These look like little pom-poms is what I remember them as a kid in my grandmother's yard. And actually, they really kind of will fall apart when you pick them. They very easily pull away from each other and almost looks like little yellow snow flying. So then you've got the two that's on the plate together with the last two. This one's a very early one. Lasts a little bit longer than forsythia. I have these growing in my yard. I've got forsythia, but I think the Kerria Japonica is so pretty and such a stunner from the, you know, when it's blooming in spring, you really, I've got two of them and these bushes are huge. And there's the last two. Now, if you want to do, I've got a little place here, rather than do another big pom-pom, what I've done is eliminated the four and made a smaller one. And they do, like it's just starting out on the branch. Not quite a bud, but, you know, just that it's starting to open. So what I did was just cut the three. And then the plate with the last two, I cut them twice. So you've got three of the second largest size, and then the two and two. And it just gives you a little smaller flower there to starting out on the branch as it's growing. I think it's kind of nice to have that smaller size. And these are the last little two that go in the center. There we go. See how it makes for a nicer one. So let's do our leaves. Now you can certainly cut them out of colored cardstock like I've done before. They come three on a plate. And you can cut as many as you like to fill it. It is a very full, bushy plant. So I'm using two shades of a brighter green. These are really bright leaves, and they have the type of leaf is called serrated. So it's got that very jagged edge to it, which makes them really, really pretty. So unusual from some of the other leaves blooming in the spring. I'm just coloring the back in a solid color here, just to color it in. Now let's bring our leaf pad in. with the right side facing down, we're going to add a stem line. And then I pinch that down and actually crease right across that stem line. And you're going to add a little bit of shading with some pan pastel there, that bright green to really highlight that stem line. And then these do have veins on either side. I'm adding those veins to match up. Now, if you'd like to highlight your veins, you can do a fine liner and just lightly go over them, because these are so definitive. And then I'm going to grab my tweezers, bring in my pad here. I'm going to change out my tip to the medium ball stylus here so I can add some shaping to the leaf. So you're going to pinch and then place it down. I've raised it up a little bit from the pad, but I hold on to the tweezer. It's easier that way to give you a nice shape to the leaf. Move these aside and bring our project back in. And then using the tweezers, I can start placing some of those leaves. On my branch here. Tucking some in, and then some little ones, those little new leaves that are down closer to the bottom here. Now the last thing that makes this complete is adding our little ladybug. So let me get her colored up here. Use my tweezers to hold her down a bit and color her head. Ladybugs will make sure you have no aphids on your plants, so they're very beneficial to gardeners. We love them. And then I'll use my eraser here to set her down. And I'm going to put that next to the smallest ball stylus back in again. And press down. So she's got some cupping to her. Oops. And then you can add, put it right here. Oops, that one's got a bubble there. Oh, well. This is why you should always test your glue out on your little sheet there. Let's set her down. And then if you like, you can add a little bit of glaze to her. But this just brings the highlight in to the, you know, despite the forecast, I've stamped there, live like it's spring. And that's the way we should always feel. Pinch these together a little bit. There we go. That's the Kerria Japonica.